today. Try to keep the possessions as limited as they can here against the powerful Indiana team.
Indiana controlling the opening tip. Meeks gives it up to Cheney, then makes the cut. Indiana crashing hard for the basketball, but it falls into the hands of a Red Raider. And here they come. Bryant Moore. And around it goes, and there's that perimeter shooting. And they cash in immediately. Stacy Bailey.
They made 12 three-pointers in that loss to New Mexico State, which was an all-time school record. So, again, James Dickey likes that outside shot.
Yeah, with a little weave of its own as Greg Graham sets it from the point. And good hustle across the court by a couple of players, saved by Indiana and two by Anderson as he connects for the Hoosiers' first field goal.
A really fortunate save that time for Indiana as the ball came right into Anderson's hands, about 15 feet from the basket, right where he likes it.
Ashley slid his pivot foot. First turnover of the game. Both teams starting out pretty well.
We're going to see some good defense today. Both teams like to concentrate on defense. I was impressed with Texas Tech's warm-up. As they came out, most teams would shoot layups. Texas Tech went right to the defense, some one-on-one stuff, and really showed their concentration on that even in the warm-up.
Well, I think now the official score has called Eric Harmon over, the referee, and I think we have a clock malfunction. Now it's set 45, but no, it kicks down to 24 again. So there's Coach Knight looking for his 466th win in the opening game of this INB Hoosier Classic.
Of course, the 24 seconds represents the NBA shot clock. The 45 you see there is the college. And they need to have some numbers in between.
We welcome stations along our Raycom network watching us tonight back in Texas. Texas Tech home country, Lubbock, Texas, seeing our game tonight. We welcome you. Our weather is about the same as yours, we understand. It's a little chilly, no snow on the ground, but good winter weather that lets you know that this is basketball time. We had this problem, if you remember, at the Hoosier Dome last against Kentucky when a clock malfunctioned. Actually, it was the scoring box that carries all the paraphernalia, all the chips and everything. It just totally malfunctioned. And they're going to have to set it up.
A little more difficult for the players if the clock does not work. It's kept at the scorer's bench. 45 seconds, obviously a long time. It shouldn't come into play, but just when you say that, there'll be times when, of course, it will. So you see the two coaches talking in the background there.
We can once again run down the starting lineups. Ashley and Dale with Flemons in the middle, Bailey and Moore. As you look at Bob Knight and James Dickey, and they apparently have made their decision.
They've got an alternate plan, I'm sure, in case this doesn't work out. The coaches seem to be in agreement. They want to proceed with the game. I mean,
exactly.
A coach is in the locker room. He's got his team ready. They come out. We're 1 minute and 4 seconds into the game, and all of a sudden there's a slowdown, and your player's going to lose a little edge as both teams have just been standing on the floor. Now you see James Dickey call his team back together, and Indiana comes over to the bench. So if it doesn't get solved here in a short period of time, I'm sure the coach would rather see him just play ball.
To clarify, the clock here at Market Square Arena that keeps the time, the elapsed time or play time, 45 seconds or 24, is one of these combination clocks that can convert either to college or to professional sports. And for that matter, they can set virtually any time on the clock they want to. Apparently, what has happened over there, the chip that controls this programming is malfunctioning. Now they've got it set back on 45, but it kicks immediately back to 24. So we sit and wait. I tell you that this, once again, is the 10th annual Classic. And Indiana has won the previous 9. Indiana has won all 13 Indiana Classics. Played down in Bloomington.
Some added Hoosier flavor today as Indiana State will meet Kent State later on tonight. Of course, Tate Slock is the coach at Indiana State, who spent some years as Coach Knight's assistant before taking over that job.
we had mentioned at the outset of the program, there's on the right is Scott May, played for Indiana. In the middle is Mike Banham, who was just an outstanding Indiana Pacer many, many years ago. And, of course, the fellow on the left played for both the Pacers and Indiana and played for the 76ers. That's Big George McGinnis, big man.
Oh, there's a lot of points sitting right there in a row, aren't there?
I tell you. A lot of defensive position underneath, too. Those guys played a lot of basketball. The crowd, and interestingly enough, I would imagine that there is just as much uncertainty about this condition in a crowd of around 15,000 or 16,000 as there would be with the players. But it would have decidedly more effect. That's Steve Risley with a big yawn there.
A lot of the guys try to get back, Chuck, to especially Indianapolis. A lot of the former players live here in Indianapolis. Mm-hmm. Steve Alfeld is here. Of course, Steve Downing really puts the tournament together. So I think it's not unusual to see in the stands a lot of the guys. Coach is still talking about it.
Many of these players that we're talking about, you folks watching us in Texas, should be aware Steve Downing was a great player for Indiana, also played at Washington High School in Indianapolis, but he played for Indiana and was privileged enough to play 2 years for Bob Knight. He was recruited by Lou Watson before Bob Knight, and then when Bob came in, he had Steve for 2 years, and Steve did the excellent job of, and had almost the insurmountable job of trying to handle Bill Walton and UCLA in the 1973 finals in St. Louis. Did a pretty good job before fouling out.
Well, now Coach Knight's gone over to the Texas Tech huddle with James Dickey giving some instructions to his team. Just trying to figure out how to progress with the game, I think, more than anything else.
Well, that appears to be, it appears now they're going to play without the clock. They will call it off the PA.
He puts it up there, it runs with the game
clock. Okay, there we go. All right, we have that all straight right now.
So when the shot clock gets down to 15 seconds at the scorer's bench, they will announce on the PA system 15 seconds left, so the players will have some idea. Not as good an idea, of course, with this clock being right above the backboard. But like I said, it usually doesn't come into play, especially this early in the ballgame.
That foreign voice that you heard was Rick Hartzell, one of our officials, giving us how they were going to play. Okay, so that is the game clock, 18:51, showing you that we are just underway here. Indiana trailing 3-2. The Hoosiers with the ball. Indiana with a spread offense. And try to feed inside. Henderson's pass to Meek is picked off. A drive to the basket. And off the rim, no good. As Clemens, with a great opportunity from Moore, just can't find the ring.
Good man-to-man defense by Texas Tech. You see him really up on the Indiana players at the three-point line and playing behind on the inside. That pass kicked away. James Dickey was an assistant at Texas Tech for a year and then got the head coaching job. This is his first year as head coach.
Feet inside. Meeks goes to Graham, and Graham connects with his first basket, and the Hoosiers have a one-point lead. This is Ashley. Back to Moore. And Daly.
See, it's a motion offense with Flemings on the inside trying to get open. Henderson. And there's the pass inside.
Oh, that's a great pass. And that, they worked that almost to perfection as Will Flemings from Paducah, Texas, hits his first field goal.
When you set up that one man low and four players outside, there's no help for Indiana from that weak side that coach counts on. And that's when that lob pass can be effective.
I'll tell you, if he's going to hit from out there, it's going to be trouble. Greg Graham with a three-pointer, and Indiana has jumped back into the lead. More. That perimeter game. And look at that. Ashley. DeMond Ashley.
It's a good little offense because you got to keep Flemings from scoring inside. If you drop back on him, they'll dish the ball back outside and let go of that three-pointer, which they're getting a better percentage of.
Great shot fake by Eric Anderson.
And we thought both these teams were good defensive teams. These players are scoring pretty easily.
9-8. Indiana with a one-point lead inside to Flemings. Back out to Dale. Lemons almost gets trapped. Here's the steal. Graham. And he's fouled as he wheels to the basket. Foul will go on Moore.
See if they give him two free throws. He threw the ball up. Watch how he comes down with his left hand, switches quickly to the right. There's the foul. Obviously not in the motion of shooting, but just kind of flipped it over his head. Referee's wise to that, and Indiana will get the ball out of bounds.
The lob in, and that's a set play. They work almost to perfection in virtually every game. Cheney to Henderson.
And the key there is quickly to release the ball. As soon as the referee hands you the ball, Cheney got rid of it on that high lob pass, and Henderson knocked it in.
11-8 Indiana, early going, 16-15, first half. Clemens. Down comes Henderson with the missed shot. Meeks will back it out. Anderson, oh, he's got Cheney, good angle. And 2 points.
A tough shot, he really hadn't faced the basket well that time. But from about 10 feet, puts Indiana up by 5.
Deflected ball right into the hands of Graham. Inside, a little bump before the shot. That will go on Ashley. Damon Ashley, 6'7" junior from Denver Manual. So with 15:38 left on the clock, first half, we have a timeout. Indiana leads 13-8. And we'll be back after these messages.
For those who always yearn for just a little more cookies and cream, we present Edie's Grand Light. Now in convenient 2-serving containers. Edie's Grand Light. Evidently, it's not your normal light.
Take beat.
Without code, you'd never be able to watch a basketball game without a ticket. That's right. The game you've been watching has been brought to you by Cole. Cole that makes the electricity that makes television possible. And a lot of other things we'd have a hard time doing without. We're Amex Cole Industries. Just think of us as a basketball power.
Great job, people.
Taste that will fill you up and never let you down. Bud Light delivers.
Etiquette dictates this is the proper serving spoon for French vanilla ice cream. Unless, of course, it's Edie's French vanilla. Edie's. Evidently, it's not your normal French vanilla.
This broadcast is presented by authority of the Big Ten Conference Incorporated and is intended solely for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this broadcast without the express prior written consent of the Big Ten Conference is prohibited.
Here's that out of bounds play. Let's watch. Cheney gets it. Texas Tech's got the defense. It just comes into Graham. Both teams shooting well. Indiana 6 of 8, 75%. Not many rebounds with that good of shooting.
Cheney, a couple of good ball fakes and a shot that comes up missing everything. Kicked away. Meeks has a knack of either being able to get a hand out into the passing lane or a leg, and he has done this, deflected I don't know how many times this year. A lot of that also could be true, too, that he has taken a pretty good defensive position and changed the passing angle, too, last. A good lob into Clemens, and that fall away is not going to fall, but right into the hands of another Red Raider. And give that basket to Allen Austin, 6'5 sophomore from Troop, Texas. So Indiana with its work cut out, leading by 3 as Anderson goes right to the basket on a good pass.
Indiana's moved the ball well on offense, looking for that open man. Another layup. Gives Indiana the 5-point lead.
Austin. This is Moore. Bailey. He He's a three-point shooter, but this one misses everything, and Indiana doesn't have the block out. Boy, Meeks in high gear tries to pick that one up in backcourt. Dale will fire. Dale will score for three.
Indiana not able to come up with that rebound. Texas Tech takes advantage of it. And Henderson had to decide whether to come out and guard Dale or to drop back on Clemens. I think he did the right thing by forcing the outside shot, but the Red Raiders make it.
That finds only the back of the rim as Cheney is now 1 for 3. Misses and into the conversion offense, and a near steal by Greg Graham out of bounds goes to the Red Raiders. Substitutions, Indiana will send in three, Chris Reynolds, Damon Bailey, and Matt Nover. And the substitution for Texas Tech, Ashing, is back in the lineup, replacing out Austin. Into Clemens. And Moore. All alone is Dale. Rebound to Reynolds. Here come the Hoosiers. They have a break going. And Bailey apparently loses that out of bounds. I think he tried to throw it off a Red Raider.
The ball
was unsuccessful.
Yeah, but blocked coming up. And as it was leaning out of bounds, Damon tried to grab it, actually batted it out of bounds. And the turnover goes to Texas Tech.
So Tech staying right in it as Dale fires from top of the key. Bailey with the rebound. And throws it away.
Anticipating that Cheney would cut to the basket, Damon led him a little too far. And that brings Jamal Meeks off the bench.
And Damon will sit down.
Indiana just not sharp as they were in their game with St. John's on Saturday when they took a lead early in the ball game. And the crowd response to Damon Bailey being taken out of the game.
Red Raiders playing tough, and there's a block against Indiana as they challenge the baseline.
Texas Tech is quick on the outside and mentioned Clemens on the inside. Watch his baseline move. Jamal forced to use the bump that time to stop Bryant Moore. Moore had a great game against New Mexico State, 22 points, and made 6 of 7 from three-point range. Allen Austin checks back in as Lamont Dale leads with 3 points.
Outside, three on the way, and that finds nothing but the edge of the rim as Matt Nover clears it for the Hoosiers. Meeks. Cheney.
Just a little tentative. They started well offensively. Now Texas Tech moves into a zone 2-3, and that's what's got Indiana taking some time.
Off to Meeks for two.
He switched the defense that time. Indiana took a little while to find the opening. Jamal with the jump shot.
Hoosier lead is back to four. Whistle stops the action. Turnover. Texas Tech with its second violation as Damon is back in replacing Jamal.
And you see the crowd reaction. Damon Bailey, a real favorite here in Indiana. He made a bad pass, got taken out of the ball game. And then, of course, right back in it now.
Reynolds to Cheney. There's a pass to Nover, deflected, and it'll be Indiana ball. Clemens is a hard worker. He is one of the hardest working 6'7 players I've seen in a long time. All alone, Cheney, and that's long off everything. Bailey makes the save, back to Nover. Cheney, penetration, two.
See, off the dribble, he seems a lot more fluid, a little easier for that jump shot. The shots he's missed, he's been standing still without a dribble. That time a little better in the flow of the offense. Calvert Cheney hits it.
Moore dishes it off. Clemens looks. Ashley draws Anderson off his feet. Blocked away. Ashley from the line. Good hustle by Bailey for Texas Tech. Both Baileys wear 22. And a whistle. And a very light hand check, but Eric Harmon makes the call. That call goes against Reynolds, his first.
Talked about rebounding being something that Texas Tech needed to emphasize, and they sure have early in the game.
Timeout. 19-13 is the score. 11-12 left to play. We'll be back after these messages from your local stations. This is the Raycom Sports Network. Left in the first half, Indiana with the 6-point lead. Here's Bailey's effort following that trip to the bench.
That's after he got back in the ball game, hustles right in, makes the save, comes back around to Cheney, and on the drive, he hits a little 5-footer.
Okay, Wintime is back in. It's going to be Texas Tech's ball. The Red Raiders doing an excellent job staying next to Indiana, and the shooting staying pretty well for Indiana, although Texas Tech has fallen off a bit. Bailey, Moore, want to go to Clemens. Indiana's double teaming him underneath as Ashley pops from outside. Demond Ashley.
Outside threat, really. Two or three of the Red Raiders can make that shot, not afraid to shoot it. James Dickey likes that style.
Anderson gives it up to Bailey, now to Reynolds. No cut as Anderson refused to move to the basket, or at least had no intention, and that's exactly where Calvert Cheney thought he was going to be. That's the anticipation that is not really needed.
That's twice Indiana's thrown the ball where they thought the Indiana player would be, and that's the mistake. You've got to throw it where he is, not where you think he's going to. And that zone defense seems to be bothering Indiana a little bit.
Oh, there's a great body move by Bailey at Texas Tech. It won't fall, however. Here comes Reynolds as the Red Raiders are back quickly defensively. All alone for three. Yes, Calvert Cheney.
With a nice job, stepped right into that shot. Brought his left foot around. And for a left-handed shooter, that's exactly the side of the floor you want to be on. Calvert nails a three.
And his lead is six. Bump. No call, no harm. Clemens, and he travels.
Literally one outside. That's twice now he's been calling travel. He's very effective on the inside, but twice now he's traveled. He's got the ball at 15 feet. Seems like a likable guy. He's always got that smile on his face. Good player.
Lamont Dale back in the lineup for the Red Raiders. Trailing by six. Anderson will try three. Yes, Target City.
The Red Raiders have gone to the zone probably to force that outside shot, but now 2 3-pointers in a row have extended Indiana's lead to 9.
Dale back to receive it from the side, deflected right in front of us. Good hands as Chris Reynolds got in just to tip it. Apparently it was touched past Reynolds by a Red Raider, so it's going to be Indiana ball.
Call was off of Bryant Moore as Reynolds nearly had the one on nobody. Jamal Meeks checks in for Chris, but a bit tip off a Red Raider gives Indiana the ball.
Greg Graham checks back in.
He's upset he didn't get it. You saw a shot of Reynolds around the bench. He knew he had a one on nobody, and that's what the players were like. Calvert Chaney comes out of the ball game, and Greg Graham's in for him. Look at him hugging on Norm Ellenberger.
Norm Ellenberger was married since our last game last. Blocking foul against the Red Raiders.
Personal foul, Texas Tech.
He's been working a lot with Calvert. I think Calvert was showing a little sign of affection there, of the help that Norm's given him, as Calvert made that three-pointer and so far has played a good game.
Bailey, Anderson off the post pass. Just takes the long bound. Here comes Moore. Ashley fakes the shot, feeds the big man, Will Clement.
That's what happens. You make a couple three-pointers, and then the defense comes out. Made a lunge that time, left Clement all alone inside.
That was a kick. Moore got in front of the ball, so it's Indiana to toss it in. And 41 left in the first half of the first game of the IMB Hoosier Classic. Meeks turns on the afterburner, misses the shot, and Ashley comes away with the board.
It's too wide open. That's a stop and go move, and as he stopped, everybody laid off him. Another dribble, he's got a layup. Just shot it up a little too hard.
And a pass goes behind Lamont Dale. Another turnover, and they're proving costly. You take away those turnovers, and the Red Raiders are in this game.
That hurt them in their last ball game. They had 22 turnovers. And that cost him against New Mexico State.
Henderson will check back in for Indiana at the next dead ball. Bailey. And a whistle and a travel against Bailey. Good close guarding by the Red Raiders forces another turnover.
Henderson comes in for Nover. Nover's done a good job on Clemens. And now Henderson goes right back on him. So Indiana will probably substitute between those two players, and their job mainly is the defense on Clemens.
Lance Hughes is in for the Red Raiders, and Alan Austin is out. Number three is Chad Collins. You saw him just give the ball up a moment ago.
It's an interesting, a lot of the concepts that Indiana uses on their motion offense, but it's all outside, or let Clemens roam on the inside. Interesting offense.
Greg Graham centers the ball. Pass inside, and the whistle.
Henderson trying to get the inside position. Ashley from behind trying to make the steal, and he gets called for the foul.
The second on Ashley. And we have timeout, 7:43 left in the first half. Indiana with a 26-18 lead and 25-18. We'll be back in just a moment.
What does it take to be a mountain man? Let's see. A mountain man must be fearless, sure-footed, willing to answer the call of the wild. But most of all, a mountain man should be thirsty for a smooth Busch beer or an easy drinking Busch Light. So, head for the mountains and see if you have what it takes to be a real mountain man. Man.
In just about every hometown across Indiana, you'll find an insurance company that's been offering the same great service for over 50 years.
Hey, Tom.
Hi, Bob.
Nice to see you.
Your Farm Bureau insurance agent.
Morning, Mrs. Taylor.
Hi, Bob.
He can insure your car, your home, your life, and your business.
Hey, Mr. Johnson.
Hi, Nikki.
I've been meaning to talk to you about insuring my stand.
We'll talk in a few years, okay?
And Farm Bureau Insurance will always be here, serving your hometown for generations to come.
You take me back to that feeling.
Remember that great feeling of rolling down the road knowing your car is safe and running right? Your professional automotive technician wants you to keep that great feeling. That's why more and more of America's top professionals are installing top-quality Goodyear belts and hoses. Protect your car with Goodyear belts and hoses installed by professionals supplied by CarQuest. And CarQuest keeps us rolling down the road.
25-18, Indiana with the 7-point advantage and a little over 7.5 minutes remaining first half. Let's look at this great hookup that they have between Ashley and Flemons.
Fake the outside shot. Nover leaves to guard the outside attempt there. The ball comes right into Flemons on a good pass. He gets the layup.
Does a perimeter offensive game such as Texas Tech likes to run, does it cause you more problems defensively, Lance?
You really have to adjust to it. You got a strong guy like Flemons in there. Like I said, you can't really double team him because then you're giving up that 3-point shot on the outside.
Inside, Henderson makes a good move, misses the shot. Well, he had that ball all but down inside the basket.
They've been working with him on that drive to the basket. And instead of flipping that layup, just to finish that off with a slam dunk. And that time he got everything except the ball to go in the basket.
Dale, Greg right in his face.
See, Flemons will come out and back pick to try to get guys open on layups to the basket. And then after he does that, he goes inside the post again.
And Collins sets a perfect pick as Damon Ashley hits for his third 3-pointer.
Mentioned they just broke a school record by scoring 12 3-point baskets in the loss in their last ball game, and they're on a pace now to equal that.
Well, so is Indiana. Jamal Meeks hits for his second of the year. He now has 5 points. He is 2-for-4 from 3-point range. Oh, all alone underneath. There's the back cut. And Indiana with a good adjustment, but tipped in. I think they'd give that to number 4 just to check Lance Hughes.
And Indiana, the 1-on-1 defense is so important. They're trying to force you guard Flemons 1-on-1. And Indiana's help is being taken away.
Bailey misses the easy shot. Comes Collins. Now Hughes. Good ball motion. Red Raiders really keep it moving, and so do the players keep moving.
Well-disciplined offense. They're taking their time. That's the guy they want to go to.
Down in the well and out. Here's Bailey with the rebound. As the clock ticks down, 5.5 minutes remaining. Inside, Nover just muscles his way right to the boards for his first bucket.
Strong move. Lamont Dale, 6'3", 215, was on him, and Nover just used some strength to get that shot off the backboard.
Meeks picks Collins up. Flemons. Ashley lets it fire right into the hands of Henderson. Up to Nover.
Good play by Nover. He was on the fast break, but that's not where he wanted him to have the ball. He stops his dribble, gives it up, and ends up getting a jump shot at the other end.
Henderson had already sagged over to the help side of the floor for that rebound, but it took a short bound. Henderson tries to get that ball, but I guess he and Flemons collided underneath. Apparently, no foul. Out to Dale for three. Yes!
Good look outside as Indiana collapsed inside as the ball comes in. It's kind of like we see in the Soviet game when they bring the ball in, then pop it way back to the outside for the 3-pointer, and the Red Raiders hit another one.
Bailey is alone for three. That won't fall. Flemons clears it for the Red Raiders. Here's Collins. Hughes drives on Bailey. Nope. Puts it back up and scores.
He had to shoot that one left-handed as he drove the baseline. The backboard blocked him out, but it did put him in good position for the tap, and Texas Tech's within 2 points now.
Near a steal and a bump and a foul. We'll go against Texas Tech. Lance Hughes called for his first personal. 6'4 freshman from Georgetown. And we have a timeout. 3:52 left in the first half. 30-28 is the score. We'll be back after these messages from your local stations. This is the Raycom Sports Network.
right, that was Hughes.
Exception of plays that we'll see coming up from that and over, Indiana's game has been pretty much an outside contest.
It has. Watching over inside, he uses a shot fake and then bowls his way in, a hard shot off the glass, but he gets it to go. And for Texas Tech, this is Lance Hughes. See how he had to flip to that left hand, but look, it puts him in good position. He's got four Hoosiers around him, but he's able to tip it back in to bring Texas Tech to within two.
Indiana with the ball and the two-point lead, 30-28. Let's see what the Hoosiers try to do with it here. Almost throws it away. Three on the way. Nope. And Cheney tries to follow. The Red Raiders are there to pull it down. Ward. Loose ball. And saved right back into the hands of Henderson. I tell you, he just never quit. Chris Reynolds just kept running it down. I was waiting for a whistle.
I think he was too. You see how he hesitates. He ran down the sidelines thinking the ball might go out of bounds. He realized it didn't, picked it up, and quickly got it to Henderson.
So Allen gets his second field goal. A little bumping inside as Reynolds went down. And popping it out from outside is Chad Collins.
An important part of the game now for Texas Tech. Flemons is out, taking a little rest, and he's their main go-to guy, but still they're hanging tough.
Back over to Cheney, and that's not going to follow. Tipped in on the soft bound by Eric Anderson.
That's what Eric needs to do, help a little bit more in the rebounding. We know he's a good shooter. Needs to help in that leadership and the rebounding. That time an easy tap.
Indiana had a good switch on the attempted back cut by the Red Raiders that time. The Hoosiers adjusted that move. Now behind the screen, Moore lets it fly. And over the back as Anderson went for the ball, the foul goes against Allen Austin. Austin's first. He's a sophomore, 6'5". From Troop, Texas.
So Nova checking back in. Indiana has held its last four opponents under 40% shooting. And right now, Texas Tech is 12-28, 43%.
Indiana has in the backcourt Meeks and Reynolds. And up front, it will be Nova, Anderson, Cheney. 1:58 inside 2 minutes. Very uneventful first half, unless you want to talk about the three-point efforts of Texas Tech, and there has been plenty of that. Off the rim, no good. Rebound they have taken, the red jerseys have. Just great blockout position off the boards. I don't think Indiana has any more than maybe one or two offensive rebounds last.
That was a big key. They're not a big team, but they really have done the job against Indiana here in this first half.
Hoosiers with some good pressure defensively. Inside, this is Flemons. And he has to back it out. Bailey. Up and good by Will Flemons.
Took that fade away and made it. Again, we've never seen an offense like this, Chuck, but it really fits the talent of this team very well. Only down two now.
Feed underneath, up to the glass goes Chris Reynolds from, guess who, Jamal Meeks. Led the team in assists last year. Anderson fought through. Bailey, guarded by Meeks. again, they try the back cut. If it doesn't work, then they go for the pick or the screen.
Good position there. Let's see if Jamal holds up for one shot.
Tried to feed Cheney, was fouled going through. Now will they give him two?
Took the drive to the basket that time. Only 23 seconds on the clock when the ball came in. Might have taken that ball back out. He felt he had the opening, went, took it in. And now we'll get two shots, but that still leaves the Red Raiders now with the last shot of the half.
And 20.8 seconds remaining in this first half. So Moore's back in, Collins out, as Texas Tech has stayed right in this first half. Jamal was not here at the last game, last two games, as a matter of fact. We had his uncle passed away, and he returned to Freeport to attend the services. Missed both games, although he did get back and was in street clothes for the second game. Clock running down to 15 seconds.
Big possession right here. If the Red Raiders hit, really builds their confidence, makes it a four-point game.
Moore off his foot. Here comes Cheney on the drive. Up and good. Desperation shot as the buzzer sounds. We've come to the end of the first half. Well, a big turnaround, about 6 points there in the last 25 seconds. Gives Indiana an 8-point lead. That's the end of the first half with the score. Indiana 40, Texas Tech's Red Raiders 32. Tonight's game is brought to you in part by Bud Light. Everything else is just a light. By your local 76 dealers who invite you to go with the spirit of 76. By Counter, lock and load closed handling system. By Farm Bureau Insurance and the more than 600 Farm Bureau Insurance agents across Indiana. And by Edie's Grand Ice Cream, made in Indiana with Hoosier pride.
Corn growers, rootworm protection has taken on a whole new shape. Introducing the Lock and Load closed handling system, the new safer way to handle your insecticide. Each lock and load container opens automatically when attached to your planter lid. Just lock it on and it loads. It's fast, easy, and dust-free. New Lock and Load, available only at your Cyanamid AgriCenter dealer.
There aren't any fax machines or PCs to help you at this job. And your career path is largely determined by the mood of your horse. So why would anyone choose to work up here in the mountains? Maybe it's the fringe benefits.
Tis the season for giving, and that's just what Indiana University employees have been doing. IU Update is coming up next. Welcome to another edition of IU Update. Indiana University students, faculty, and staff members have been contributing an increasing amount of money to the United Way in recent years, but 1991 has been the best ever. Almost every campus exceeded its fundraising goal this year. In Monroe County, IU Bloomington campus contributions amounted to nearly one-third of all money raised for the United Way.
It's very important that all our campuses become an integral part of the community where they reside. And one of the ways we can demonstrate that partnership is to be active in the United Way campaign. And that's why I'm so proud of Indiana University's participation in the United Way throughout the state.
Even the IU men's and women's basketball teams got involved this year, donating $10,000 in rights fees paid for televising an intra-squad game. And United Way is not the only philanthropy supported by the university. The National Panhellenic Council says IU sorority houses are the best in the nation when it comes to philanthropy and scholarship. The IU Panhellenic Council has been recognized for programs which promote academics as well as service to charitable organizations. IU Update will continue in a moment.
We are the faculty at Lincoln Elementary School in Hammond, Indiana. We are all Indiana University graduates, and we have but one thing to say. Go Big Red! Go Big Red! Go Big Red! Go Big Red!
私の言ってることがわからないのはあなただけじゃないですよ。日本で企業に勤めてるアメリカ人のほとんどもわからないのです。実のところ、アメリカ政府の外交官の多くが外国語が話せないのです。それなのに在米外交官のほとんどは英語を流暢に話してます。 It's getting tough for America, and one of the most important universities in America just got tougher. Indiana University, we're all for you.
Two Indiana University professors have received prestigious academic recognition. Professor Norman Pace has been elected to the National Academy of Sciences and to the American Academy of Arts and Sciences. Pace is a biologist who was involved in the discovery that RNA as an enzyme can carry out chemical functions. Meanwhile, Professor Eleanor Ostrom has also been elected to the American Academy of Arts and Sciences. She is a political scientist and does research on how institutions affect human behavior. Doctors inside the IU School of Medicine are conducting DNA research, which has implications for both health and safety. In addition to studying genetically linked diseases, researchers are also using genetic fingerprinting, matching suspects to material found at crime scenes. And during our halftime show tomorrow night, we'll tell you about a classroom on wheels that is getting young students interested in science. And we'll also tell you about an innovative IU program on the school's Northwest campus that is helping inner city school children and teachers. Right now, it's time to go back inside Market Square Arena. Reporting for IU Update, I'm Mike Piper.
Here's our halftime score, 40-32. The Hoosiers jumping out with six quick points in the last 25 seconds. Let's take a look now at our Bud scoreboard. These are all contests with late start. Iowa is playing at Butler. We'll try to give you that score as quickly as we can. Wisconsin at home tonight. Washington State is playing the Badgers. Minnesota at home against Oregon. And Creighton is playing Northwestern. We'll be back with more halftime activities following these messages from your local stations. This is the Raycom Sports Network. All right, okay. Thank you. Well, it's 52 seconds. 52.
A minute eight to go. It was 34-32, yep. And then Indiana scored three baskets in the last 52 yep. seconds.
Okay.
Because it's a two-point yep. game, you 50, know, otherwise it's a two-point game to have.
Yeah, 52 seconds. Well, I said 24.
Indiana's averaging 30 free throws a game. They've taken two in the first half.
Well, they're just not getting inside. They're not doing anything.
No.
Anything inside at all. Their game has been a perimeter game. Okay. That still doesn't bother you there? Bob Straight. Yeah. It's the first game of the 1991-92 INB Hoosier Classic, and Indiana has the 8-point lead. We'll be back with the Farm Bureau Insurance halftime report following these messages from your local stations. This is the Raycom Sports Network.
Kentucky fan.
Yeah, he's a Kentucky fan.
All right. Okay. Ashley has with 11. Okay.
Here's a look at this.
All right. Okay. All right. So you're going to start with Ashley and then Cheney.
6 of 10 from the 3-point range. So their total field goal percentage is 0.433.
All right. Okay.
Their 3-point percentage is 600. They've had no free throw attempts. For Indiana, the Hoosiers 17.
What are you doing down there?
From the field. There we go. 4 of 8 on 3-point attempts. Thus, their field goal percentage overall is 0.567. Their 3-point attempt, 500, of course. Indiana, 2 attempts at the line.
And now the halftime report brought to you by Farm Bureau Insurance. Statistically, Laz, these two teams appear on the surface to be pretty even. We saw Texas Tech earlier with around 36% from the field. They picked that up a little on 13 of 30.
I'll tell you what's disturbing, though. Indiana's free throws, 2 of 20. They've been averaging 30 free throws taken so far per game. They're making 22. Indiana's not getting the ball inside, not creating opportunities for them to the line. Texas Tech has yet to shoot a free throw. There you see the three-point shooting. 6 of 10 for Texas Tech. And they're right on the line with tying that record they set in the last ball game with 12. 17 rebounds, a real key for Texas Tech staying in the ball game. 8 turnovers, but only 4 for Indiana.
Indiana's scoring is led by Eric Anderson with 11, but Calbert Cheney has countered with 9 very good points.
He's played a smart game. Let's watch him now. He gets his feet set. He's moving toward the basket as he makes this 3-point shot.
Would you say that his game is really picking up in all aspects? Do you think he's getting his defensive mind back, Laz?
Yeah, I think he is. He's concentrating on what he needs to do out there. One thing I haven't seen in today's ball game, though, is a lot of enthusiasm.
Okay.
I haven't seen a lot of talk on defense, and I just haven't seen that same flow of enthusiasm that really gets things going.
All right, here's a good example of Calvert and the effort that he's making underneath. Good inside play, stays right with the ball.
See how he didn't go after the player, went after the ball, knocked that shot away. And for Texas Tech, Damon Ashley has 9 points, all on 3-point shots. Will Flemons, their leading scorer, held down to only 6 points. But here's Ashley from the outside as he knocks down that 3-pointer, a big part of their offense in the first half.
The rest of the scoring, Flemons with 6, along with Lamont. Hughes, Bailey, and Austin add the remaining of the scoring for the Red Raiders. And that's the Farm Bureau Insurance halftime report. We'll be back with more halftime activities following these messages.
In 1953, I knocked on the door that leads to success. That was the year I became an Indiana University freshman. Later, when I entered the job market, I discovered a world of opportunity was open to me. That's one of the reasons why Dow Chemical is a major supporter of the IU Chemistry program. We know that many of tomorrow's leaders will start right here. I did, and I'm proud to be an IU alumnus. Indiana University lets you do great things.
There's a pride in Indiana that's there for you and me. Can you really feel it? It's Hoosier history. It's the greatest chance of winning. It's tried and you'll see. Instant cash and prizes from the Hoosier Lottery.
$20,000 instant, up to $50,000 in merchandise.
To the dismay of many, there are only 24 hours in a day.
That is almost done.
So before you head off on a sales call...
Wait. Let me see the bottom.
You can go in now.
Before you begin to grapple with a business letter...
Oh, please, change the bottom.
GTE would like to suggest a slightly more productive alternative.
I'm sorry?
Now, you're going to want to sit down for this one. The phone. Because if time is money, this is a bank.
This game is brought to you in part by Busch Beer, head for the mountains. By your local 76 dealers who invite you to go with the spirit of 76. By Counter Lock and Load Closed Handling System. By Farm Bureau Insurance and the more than 600 Farm Bureau Insurance agents across Indiana. And by Edie's Grand Ice Cream, America's finest premium ice cream made in Indiana with Hoosier pride. Both teams back around their coaches, and the buzzer has sounded. It's going to be Nover, Cheney, Reynolds, and there's a little discussion that's taking place just before it. I think they're discussing the clock. We are still playing without the clock, or are we? There's 45 seconds on the shot clock now. Let's see if it works. Now pick up the rest of Indiana's starting lineup. It's Anderson, Cheney, Nover, and the two guards, Jamal Meeks and Chris Reynolds.
The end of that half was real important, Chuck, as Indiana had a 34-32 lead with a minute to go. Indiana ends scoring three baskets to get an 8-point lead, especially the last play when Texas Tech could have dropped the lead to 4 points. Cheney makes the steal, goes to the other end, and gets the lead to 8 points. Let's see if Indiana can continue the way they ended the last minute of that first half.
Ashley. As Texas Tech, with possession to start this second half, begins its attack toward the Indiana basket. Moore. Indiana with a pretty good job so far defensively. There's Anderson trying to cut it off and succeeds in doing so as Cheney got the deflection, and on the drive, Reynolds gets the 2 points.
That was Nover on the defense. That lob pass into Flemons, he was able to knock away, and Indiana scores their 8th straight point.
Patience as Bailey gives it up to the glass, and a blocking foul. Fans don't like that call. That will go against Cheney.
Cheney came down the baseline to help. Let's see if he was in good position or not. No, it wasn't quite set. See how he's leaning to the right. And that's the reason for the foul.
Look of anguish on Mr. Cheney's face. Junior from Evansville, Harrison.
Number 32 at the line.
Bob Knight is up as Ashley is ready to shoot too. They are not a good free throw shooting team, averaging about 67%. And Ashley, much below that, he is only 30% from the line. From Denver, Colorado.
It's Damon Ashley. It looks like it should be Damon. Pronounced Damon. And he's been hot from that three-point line. There's a little three-quarter court zone trap they like to use. It helped in their high amount of turnovers they had in their last ball game.
and add one more to it as Indiana tries to get a lead pass down to Anderson. Goes off his hand, and there you see the look of concern on Coach Knight's face.
Indiana worked against the press this morning in their workout here at Market Square Arena.
It's a well-coached team, Chuck. They've tried a lot of different things. There's a steal.
Up for an easy two. Chris Reynolds showing his burst of speed and his second field goal here in the second half.
James Dickey's brought this team in well prepared. They've slowed the tempo down. They've taken what Indiana's given, a three-point shot. And there you saw that three-quarter zone. Again, just something to see if they can change what Indiana wants to do.
Indiana with good help from Nova there as Reynolds quickly gets back. Here's Moore. Moore has a quick start, very quick first step. Ashley. Back to Bailey. And that's not going to fall as Matt Nova clears it.
Nova, the Texas Tech bench wanted to push on Nova underneath. They didn't get it. And now a call goes against Jamal on the drive to the basket on the charge.
Aggressively taking it inside, and there were too many red jerseys in there. They plugged up the lane, and he commits the foul.
Fakes left, comes into the right. And right there is a good position. Lamont Dale was there, took the charge, and the turnover gives the ball back to Texas Tech.
As Lance Hughes reports back in for the Red Raiders. This is Moore guarded by Reynolds.
A double pick low that time.
Cheney pulls it down off the board to Meeks. Indiana tries to set it up. They have an 11-point lead. Under to Anderson for two.
Well, Indiana's had a great run here. The last 6 points of the first half have come out now to that 13-point lead. Timeout by Texas Tech.
17 and a half minutes left to go. Indiana with the big lead, 46-33, their biggest of the game. We'll be back after these messages.
Up here, the days run long. Sometimes the job is all uphill, but you keep on going. And once you've made it all the way to the top, the mountains will take your breath away and remind you there's no place you'd rather be than right here, right now.
The grandkids are coming over this afternoon, so Sally is making her special homemade ice cream. It's a closely guarded family recipe, using only the finest, freshest ingredients. Sure, doing things the old-fashioned way does take a little extra time, but it's worth it. Because it keeps the precious little darlings away from her Edie's almond praline. Edie's. Evidently, it's not your normal almond praline.
And the open's on C, stand by roll C.
Without Coke, you'd never be able to watch a basketball game without a ticket. That's right. The game you've been watching has been brought to you by Coke. Coke that makes the electricity that makes television possible. And a lot of other things we'd have a hard time doing without. We're Amex Coke Industries. Just think of us as a basketball power.
Hey, great job, people.
46-33 as we attempt or prepare to come back into this game. Will be Texas Tech to toss it in on the far side.
See, Indiana's outscored Texas Tech 16-5 in the last 6 minutes and 30 seconds. Has really extended that lead now at 13 points.
Indiana owned virtually every statistical category in the first half of play with the exception of rebounding. That's where we thought they would shine. And ironically, last, they had only two offensive boards. We had talked about that. Look at this great move by Dale. Lamont Dale for his first second half basket.
Very quick that time. Again, you can't emphasize be concerned about that 3 points so much that you let him drive by, and that's exactly what Dale did that time.
Anderson posts up Nover. To Meeks. The shot clock is working. We do have a 45-second shot clock. It's ticked down now to 19.
Indiana having trouble setting up. It's a 2-3 zone. Indiana just working the perimeter instead of trying to get the ball inside.
There's Meeks. And that won't fall. Meeks goes for the ball, knocks it out of bounds. It was off the leg. How do they award it? It's to Indiana. And that upsets Lamont Dale right in front of us and upsets James Dickey.
Looked like he wanted a foul. Steve Wellmer under the basket didn't make a call. He looked to the back referee and gives Indiana the ball. Weak pass inside, nearly picked off.
That's been one of the shortcomings of Indiana's game last.
Not crisp on their passes. Led to quite a few turnovers.
Anderson forced that. Got a little extra shove on that ball as he took up or went up for the shot. Blocked shot as Clemens went for two. Here's the steal back. Blocked by Nover. They'll call a foul.
Looked like he blocked it cleanly, but he pushed with his other hand on the body. Good steal that time by Brian Moore. Indiana's offense just taking too many outside shots, not waiting for the ball to come in. Watch the block, though, by Anderson. A good play defensively. Nover's got the ball. The quick outlet is cut off by Moore. And now it's one-on-one. And there is, well, didn't see that left hand. It looked like it might have been on the shooting arm where Nover committed the foul.
So Bryant Moore, a 6'1 senior from San Diego, California, scores his first point from the line. He is only a 67% shooter from the charity stripe. Second is up and also good, so he improves on that average. And the Red Raiders inch their way back. They're trailing by just 9.
There's that press again. Indiana gets it across the line this time without turning it over.
See what the Hoosiers can do against this zone this time. Cheney will not find the mark. Out it comes, and this is a 4-on-2. That is great agility and body control by Brian Moore.
Now that brings the Red Raider bench up too. 6 points in a row now before Nover is able to hit that baseline shot.
Nover's second field goal. Still a 9-point, 48-39 Indiana lead. Hughes, Dale, Moore. And he travels.
Got his feet caught up there. Travel gives the ball back to Texas Tech.
DeMond Ashley is back in the lineup for Texas Tech, checking to see who he replaces, and he replaces Dale.
Let's watch Bryant Moore here as he just takes two big steps. A little contact there. It felt it knocked him off balance, but still able to get that shot. A wild pass now by Jamal. And goes right to Coach Knight.
Enough said. And the fan reaction indicates what Coach Knight's reaction is.
11 for Texas Tech, Indiana's 7th turnover. But Indiana really capitalized on the points off turnovers with 15.
Well, Nover forces another Raider turnover there with good pressure. That still doesn't make the general happy, does it?
No, this press has caused Indiana some problems. Starts at three-quarter court and continues, and here's another steal.
Gave the ball up too soon, and the slam dunk by Lance Hughes.
Crowd is buzzing, but it's not because of the way Indiana's playing. It's what the Red Raiders are doing defensively. Got themselves back in the ball game now, down 7 points. And this sticky little zone defense at the other end is making it tough for Indiana to score.
48-41. Texas Tech is back to within 7.
Indiana's got to get that ball inside. They're too content taking the outside shot. They need to get Cheney or Anderson cutting up from behind on that baseline and getting that 5-foot shot. Shot clock down to 12 seconds.
Meeks for 3.
Helps a little bit right there as the crowd comes to life. Jamal hits from the baseline.
Yeah, but Laz, back to what you said before, Indiana has no inside game at all.
That's the reason that they're not going to the foul line. You can't rely on that three-point shot to fall all the time, as seen in Indiana's shooting today. They're only 5 out of 12.
Well, and just as soon as they drop it off, Bailey hits for 3. He now has six, and both his attempts have come from the three-point range. Gives it up to Anderson. Meeks with a feed and the reverse layup by Matt Noble.
There you go. There's the ball movement Indiana's looking for. No dribbling, just move the ball on the pass. See who the open guy is. That time Noble even used the rim there to fend off any defensive effort. Got it to go in.
Hughes back to Moore. And a little bump, no basket. Says Steve Wilmer, the foul will go against Meeks. And I have him for three.
Let's watch that last series. Anderson quickly to Jamal, over to Nover, reverse layup, good movement. That's where you get the chances to get fouled. Damon Bailey checks back in the lineup.
Now the important thing here is Bailey has to pick up the tempo of this game.
Well, not so much the tempo, Chuck, as the Indiana trying to get that ball inside, although Damon can take that outside shot. Indiana's got to look for Chaney and Anderson getting open inside.
Three on the way, and no good as Bailey's shot is saved once again by the Red Raiders. Dropped back to Flemons.
Really haven't gone to Flemons as much as they thought. That's because the three-point shot's been open.
Bailey guarding Bailey. And a trap. Ashley has had his problems tonight. And those floor mistakes, those violations occur at the most inopportune time for the Red Raiders.
They kill you just when you're building that momentum, getting back in the ball game. They're down nine right now. Break up. Not getting that shot at the basket, crucial.
Indiana looks right down the throat of a 2-3 zone again. Chaney. Two.
See the difference there, but he could have taken that 3-point shot from the outside. He used the fake. Got a quick dribble, makes that now a 12-foot shot on the move, and that's a much better shot for Chaney. Not quite going inside, but pretty close to it.
Indiana's lead is 11. Good help. Moore from outside. He is about a foot behind that three-point line. There's a soft pass almost picked off by Chaney. And a travel. It's huge. With too many body fakes, turns it over. We have a timeout. 11:38 remaining to be played. Indiana has the lead, 55-44. We'll be back after these messages from your local stations. This is the Raycom Sports Network. What I meant by the tempo, he has to get into the tempo.
Okay.
Of the game. That's what I
thought you meant.
No, and I made a mistake by saying it the way I did.
Okay.
But you're right.
How we sound? You don't know? Huh?
Your attendance this evening, ladies and gentlemen, for the first night of the 10th IMB Hoosier Classic, 15,595. 15,595. Remind you, tickets will be available for the second evening of this IMB Hoosier Classic. They'll be on sale Saturday here at the Market Square box office.
Okay.
Indiana has taken an 8-point halftime lead and stretched it into an 11-point advantage at the 11:38 mark of the second half, 55-44. Three-point field goals. Now, that's an interesting comparison. Texas Tech, 60% in the first half, Laz, and just 1-for-3 here in the second.
Indiana's concentrated on moving out. When the Texas Tech players getting ready to take that shot, they've only allowed three shots. Only one to go in, so obviously a change coach not made at halftime.
Indiana with Bailey and Reynolds in the backcourt. Moore guards Reynolds. This is Hughes on Bailey. Finds the post, and a back in, and a block as Cheney is just getting ready to turn and wheel toward the bucket.
Calvert has changed his game now from standing at the three-point line to posting up inside. This is good, I think, on his part. He's moving there quickly. He'll hit that shot a lot more as James Dickey looks on. He's been frustrated with the amount of traveling calls just recently called on his team.
Inside to Nover, off the post, no shot. Gives it up, and nobody comes to the ball.
And Texas Tech has gone back to their man-to-man defense. They started the game that way. Indiana got a quick start, a quick jump on the lead, and then went to a zone. But now they've come back to a man-to-man, and that's why Chain's been able to get the ball inside.
To Nover. Nover's hands have been hurt a lot since last year. He would have lost the ball on that slap.
He seems a lot more comfortable, too, with guys on and putting the pressure on.
Oh, he gets it up, gets it to fall, and draws the foul off a great pass by Anderson.
That's a backdoor play. As Anderson comes up to the free throw line to receive the ball from Reynolds, and then Bailey comes on the backdoor, beats his man. Watch how he gets around Clemens, gets the shot, the chance for the free throw.
The foul on Clemens, 6'7" junior, his first. Ashley sits down. Clemens has been relatively ineffective, averaging 8.9 points per game. And Indiana misses the free throw, so Bailey having his troubles from the line. He's only 74% on the season. Austin. And that's the Hoosiers' first free throw of the second half.
Which gets three for the game. Again, well short of the 30 they've been averaging up to this point.
Moore tries to shake Bailey. Now Bailey goes to the basket. That's Bailey for Texas Tech. And a great save on the line.
Well, Rell snuck right in there and grabbed that ball before it, the Red Raiders could come up with it.
Cheney, too many times on the floor, kicks it back out to Bailey, however. All alone for three. No, doesn't go. Look at Anderson fight for the ball and a foul.
Seems to be the crowd seems to be in the game a lot more. You can see the reaction by the players. Their enthusiasm is picked up. Going after the loose balls, and that does go out of bounds to Indiana. Let's watch the other end here, the action. Drive inside, Nover comes over to help. Good offensive rebound there, but the block, watch Randall sneak right in from behind, come up with that loose ball.
Damon Bailey looking. Stacy Bailey guarding, and the whistle stops the action.
Personal foul, Texas Tech, number 23.
That's on Lamont Dale, his first. Dale comes all the way to Lubbock, Texas from Snowville, Maryland. Reynolds starts the drive. Good adjustment by Bryant, and a whistle. And now we're getting some fouls. And a lot of that is due to the fact that Indiana has picked its motion up a little bit.
Cheney's fight for position inside. Montdale picks up his third foul. And that's what's gotten Indiana to the foul line earlier in the season. Just the 15 fouls, so no shots. Reynolds scores on the inbound score.
Reynolds has eight as Indiana begins to execute just a little bit better at both ends. Clemens. And a drag of the foot, but a foul before. It goes against Indiana. Eric Harmon makes the call, and I believe he caught Nover in an infraction. He did.
Personal second foul, on Matt. Indiana, number 24, Matt Nover, his second personal.
Chad Collins back in for the Red Raiders as Bryant Moore takes a rest. 9:25 left to play. The first game of the IMB Hoosier Classic from Market Square Arena in Indianapolis. Three on the way by Bailey. It's good and a foul. Chance for a four-point play.
Eric Harmon with the call that time. Nover came out to put the pressure on. And a big play here for Texas Tech.
personal foul.
Near steal by Reynolds gives Texas Tech the 5-on-4 advantage. Indiana's moving now to try to cover up. And Nova over aggressively picks up his third foul and gives Bailey a free throw.
Third foul on Matt.
A 2-point basket for Stacey Bailey.
They say, did they say 2 points? A 2-point basket, so apparently he was on the line shooting. So Bailey now with 9 points.
It looked like a 3-point shot from here.
Sure did. Cheney outside, that's not gonna fall. Rebound, Clemens. Time working right now in favor of Indiana, but the pace of the game is working in favor of Texas Tech. They're closing the gap.
They've got to come now with some 3-point shots since Indiana's really closed down Clemens on the inside.
Inside, great move, no good. Tipped up by Clemens, no good. Foul. What? They call that on Nova.
Pushing under on the waist there by Nova. Coach Knight doesn't agree with that call. Nova's one came up with the rebound.
Mixed reaction from fans.
Well, I'd say it's pretty much against the call. If you hear the
that's not
the crowd roar. Nova picks it up. Indiana now just over the limit, so it's 1-1 now as Clemens gets up there.
Clemens' first trip to the line. Let's look again. Maybe
okay, let's watch the lower part of your screen right there. See that shove by Nova? It knocked Clemens right out of there, and the ball comes right to him. That's a good call.
Paducah, Texas, home of this man. Has 8. And the Red Raiders are back to within 10. Here's that press.
The press, yeah. Indiana doesn't need that quick shot now. They need to run that clock a little bit, make sure they get the shot they want.
Out of bounds, Indiana ball.
Ooh, near turnover that time as Texas Tech's putting on the pressure now defensively. But Indiana just needs to take a little time now, cut down the number of possessions left in the ball game, and get that good shot, try to get that free throw line, but the Raiders only with 5 team fouls.
Indiana's had difficulty with its passing angle here in the second half last, and I think a lot of that's due to the defensive pressure put on by Texas Tech. Good reverse layup by Calvert Cheney.
Getting the ball to Calvert Cheney inside is a good part of the offense Indiana wants to get done right now.
Clemens. Bailey will fire and score. Stacey Bailey.
Tough shot there. Damon Bailey had good position. A little higher arch than normal. Bailey gets it to go.
Block is called as Eric Harmon points at Lamont Dale.
Better job, Indiana, moving to the basket now. They break the press. Nova takes it right in. Dale not quite with that position set. And it'll be out of bounds to Indiana.
Substitution, but we have, I believe, a timeout. Ashley is back in and replaces Allen Austin. We do have timeout. 7:43 remaining. 61-51 Indiana. Back after these messages.
Why are you drinking so much coffee, Charlie?
I'm about to have a Farm Bureau Insurance client account review and evaluation.
It's just a fancy name for saying your Farm Bureau Insurance agent has this great new service designed to review all your insurance policies. You know how fast things change.
Client account review and evaluation.
C-A-R-E.
Farm Bureau Insurance really does care.
So what are you so worried about?
What scores big with the Big Three coaches?
Coca-Cola Classic. Diet Coke.
I pick Sprite.
You can pick any of the three in the Big Three game. Just look under Big Three caps on 2-liter bottles and win an instant prize like this exciting Pathfinder from Nissan. It's right on the money right now. Or a U.S. Air trip to Florida. Or one of thousands of free food or discounts at McDonald's.
Pick the real thing. Coca-Cola Classic. or the real cola taste of Diet Coke,
or the great lime and taste of Sprite.
Play Big Three today.
When you play the game and you're looking good, there's a Bud Light way and it's understood.
If you're into looking good, get into Bud Light. Clean, fresh taste won't fill you up, never let you down.
You can taste it, feel it, know you got it right, because everything else is just a light.
Everything else is just a light.
Bud Light.
Everything else is just a light.
Just a light.
Everything else is just a light.
61-51 Indiana. The Hoosier game, lads, is predicated upon inside play of Eric Anderson, Calvert Cheney, Alan Henderson, or Matt Nova. Here's a good example.
Good pass inside. Cheney comes up with it one-handed, and then reverse layup there hits Indiana the score. There's the shooting in the second half, just 46% for Texas Tech. Indiana at 59%.
Texas Tech has gone back into its 2-3 zone. Cheney tries the baseline. Oh, how he got that shot off, I don't know.
He kind of floats back in toward the court that time as the backboard nearly blocked him off.
Hughes. And Bailey pulls down the errant three-point shot up court quickly. Comes Indiana, misses, but a foul. And let's see. Is he going to get up? I think so. Chris Reynolds will go to the line.
I think he felt he could have made that layup. He ran into the standard there, the basket up, holds the basket up. Let's see. Dame with the lead pass outside. There's the foul. Boom. It's right into the standard there. But I think he just felt he should have made that shot instead of get a three-point play instead of the two free throws he's got now.
Chris has had some shooting problems, largely due to technique changes, Laz, that they've been making. They're trying to make him a better shooter, and one of the reasons why Coach Knight wanted to redshirt him this year was to work on his shooting, but he had to pull him out after the UCLA game when he just realized he needed his speed and quickness.
And he has done a good job this year. He's got 9 points now, his season high is 10, which he had against Vanderbilt.
Collins. Start a little weave, and they work it off this perimeter game they play inside. But it bounces and takes a Red Raider bounce.
Good defense by Bailey. See how he shut off the baseline that time.
Cheney, good position. Collins. They leave that middle open. They like to attack the middle, and there's a cut. There's a back cut and a whistle. And that will send Red Raiders Lance Hughes to the line.
Cheney caught out of position that time. The foul sends the Raiders to the line.
Bonus for number four, Hughes.
Hughes from Georgetown.
Get him out, it's what I want.
Misses on the front end of the 1-1. Cheney for three. Well, it rattled, but it was right on the mark. That's his second three-pointer.
That's what keeps him honest. He'd been concentrating so much on the inside. Let that outside shot go.
Another bad pass comes up in the hands of Indiana. Here's Bailey. Reverse back to Bailey for three. And the crowd lights up on that one. Damon's their favorite son, the sophomore from Heltonville, Indiana. He has five, and we have a timeout. 5:56 left to play. 70-51 Indiana. We'll be back after these messages from your local stations. This is the Raycom Sports Network. 70-51's the score. Well, Bailey has been the difference in the last few minutes here, Les.
Let's watch now as he, first off, cuts the drive off on the baseline, forces Texas Tech to pick the ball up.
Back to live action. And then came back at the other end to hit a three. There's a 19-point lead by Indiana right now, and that stat's very interesting. Off the rim, no good, as Nover, playing with four personals, pulls it down for Indiana. Cheney, three more.
He's on it right now.
Yes, sir.
Getting two on that, but he can see he's in the flow of the ball game now. That shot looks just like it did last year.
Galbert Cheney has an even 20. Bailey to Flemons.
11-0 now. Indiana's outscored Texas Tech in the last 2 minutes and 20 seconds.
Ashley lets it fly. No, that's Bailey.
Number 22, Stacey Bailey.
That is his fourth three-pointer. Ooh, right in front of the bench. Bailey's guarding each other. Anderson turns back, misses, but draws a foul and will go to the line as Allen Austin got an arm on the shot. His third.
Personal foul, Texas Tech. Allen Austin is third personal.
Checking back in is Ashley, Damani Ashley. And out goes Will Flemons, who's had a tough night. Leads with 8 points, two personal fouls, and 10 below his average. He's highest of the season, scoring wise, 27. Nover takes a rest. So does Reynolds. Todd Leary joins Damon Bailey in the backcourt. And the big fellow, Todd Lindemann from Channing, Michigan. Now, I guess we should say from Greenwood, Indiana, because that's where his folks have moved. Sees his first action in the game. There's Lindemann, 7-footer, freshman. Anderson hits the second, 1-for-2 from the stripe, 14 points. And the time in the game, 4 minutes, 45 seconds. Kicked away, struggle, scramble for the ball. Cheney comes up with it to Leary. And Leary wisely backs it out as the Red Raiders are back quickly. Bailey to Leary. And tries to hit Lindemann inside. Right into the hands of Ashley. Dishes it. And gets the roll, does Chad Collins.
Basket by number three, Chad Collins.
Leary tried to force that pass in the last time down to Lindemann. Caused the turnover.
Lindemann tries to set a screen. Anderson can't use it. Bailey leans in for two more. Damon Bailey has 7 all here in the second half. He's averaging 10.
He's played a good game. He got off to a slow start. Coach set him down after that bad pass, but since then he's come on well.
Ashley almost travels. And that's set up. He had plenty of time, Chad Collins did. No one seemed to want to take him. And so Indiana will go once again to its bench as Graham and Henderson are ready to check back in. Knocked away. Here's Bailey on the steal. Knocked back away out of bounds, says Eric Harmon. Last touched by Leary. So Leary just breaking down a little bit here.
There is. There you see the coaching staff. As Henderson comes back in the lineup, so does Greg Graham. And Anderson leaves.
Eric leaves with 14 points. Cheney also out of the lineup. He leaves with 20. Let's see what the Hoosiers can do with this lineup. Out of bounds, Indiana.
Good out of bounds play as they try to get the opening in the lane. Indiana right there to knock it away. You see Henderson in the lineup now.
Allen has had one of its slower games tonight, only 4 points, and hasn't really played this well on the court. Missed a couple
really
of defensive rules.
Half, right?
Yeah. And a whistle once again stops the action, and this sort of lengthens the game a little bit. 3 minutes, 6 seconds. Lance Hughes picks up his second.
It's been a tough game for Indiana. The coaching staff expected that, though. Texas Tech's really turned this team around after a losing record last year.
Leary misses. Lindemann chases it into the corner, gives it back to Leary, and the Hoosiers stay alive. Leary looks. Wants to go to the post. Back to Bailey for three. Nope. Lindemann high in the air, feeds Henderson. Bailey scrapping. Right into the hands of Leary. Back to Henderson. He's fouled. He'll go to the line.
That's great hustle there by Indiana. On the floor for the loose ball. You hear the reaction from the crowd. And that's the kind of play they like to see, not only them, but the coaching staff, too. Indiana just hasn't had enough of that. Watch Lindemann now tries to get it. Bailey can't come up with it. Just keep trying to keep it alive. Good job here by not traveling. Henderson goes down. Leary finally comes up with it. And the pass right back down. There's the foul.
And with that basket, the score is 76-58. Time for the 76-point reminder after the game. Stop by your neighborhood 76 station for quality 76 gasoline or convenience items. Indiana keeps control of the ball. Tipped in by Henderson.
Bailey kept it alive, and then Allen Henderson with the left-hand tap. Indiana really coming to life now.
Stacy Bailey. This is Hastings. Lindemann gets some body. Hughes gets the glass to work and will go to the line on the foul.
Watch the action here as Bailey taps the ball there. And a wild shot left-handed. Lindemann gets the foul and Hughes gets the basket to go.
Collins back in for the Red Raiders. There's Brown. Baron Brown, a junior from Lancaster, Texas. Another substitution. I think this is Brad Dale. It is 6'6 sophomore from Amarillo, Texas. Hughes ready to see his left-handed shot. High arch in the air, and he has 9 points.
He's a natural left-handed shooter, and Lindemann blocking that as if he was a right-handed player.
Again, Texas Tech not giving up the pressure. Up and the stop.
Right there. There you see it again, Chuck. They've really concentrated, both Henderson and Lindemann. Instead of shooting that layup, to jam it through one-handed that time, Lindemann came through.
1:52 left to play. And Indiana will put another victory into the win column for the IMB Hoosier Classic of 1991-92. Hughes, he gets a baseline move, and he gets hammered from three different directions there, but I think Greckham is going to be called for the foul. First on Greg. Well, understanding Coach Knight, Laz, a sizable victory here, 80-61, but he can't be too happy with the overall play for 40 minutes.
Right, until the first 19 minutes of that first half, Texas Tech was right there. Indiana scored three baskets right at the end of the half to get that 8-point lead, and then came out slowly in the second half and built that lead up to 20 points.
Gets the second bounce. Substitution. Richard Hastings, another freshman, 6'6 from Liberty Hill, reports in, seeing his first action. Still pressure to Bailey. Minute 25 to Lindemann. Out of bounds, Indiana. Had a chance to talk with Coach Knight this morning. I was talking, I just casually mentioned that they were coming back. They should be on sort of a high after their game at St. John, and he took issue with that. He said, for every high, there's a low. He says, we don't look at things in terms of highs. He says, we look at it in terms of our next game. And I think he just keeps over presenting that idea. Here's a steal. And the delay and the hang in the air by Greg Graham for his 7th point. I think he just keeps that ever present in the minds of the players.
Right, you want that steady increase and not the ups and downs, the peaks and the valleys. That's what you're trying to avoid.
Chad Collins counters at the other end with a three-pointer. 50 seconds remaining. Up and in. Give it to Alan Henderson.
Well, Larry's made two nice passes here in the last 30 seconds.
The tempo of the game is baseline to baseline now. Brown for three. Yes! Aaron Brown's first three-pointer of the season. 30 seconds. Inside, Lindemann. A little bit too far to make a move to the basket. Now he's in better post position. And Henderson follows.
Oh!
Bailey will follow for two. Eight seconds. One shot remaining. Collins. Brown. And no shot. We've come to the end of the game. Well, as we said, Coach Knight walks away with another victory. This is James Dickey coming down as they exchange greetings at midcourt, players and coaches. Ron Felling. And Craig Hartman, the student manager, manager of managers. But I think when they get back in the